Hello everybody, this is Attorney Shaparali, and I'm making this video quickly because we are witnessing some kind of situation when it comes to visa stamping, especially in India. In the past few days, even during the time of we had the holiday seasons, people are still calling and they are stuck in India under IN-8221G. It seems like the administrative processing, it seems like its dirty nose is coming back. And many people are seeing themselves getting stuck there. They are being issued what they call the pink slip, green slip, you name it. And that's really kind of stressful for many people, especially we are talking about people who have been applying under the drop box. That means the drop box, as you know, are for usually for people who have a what we call a who have basically no change in their cases, and they apply for it, and then suddenly they send them for an interview, and from the interview you're seeing an IN-8221G being issued, and that's really worrisome, because most of the people who call me, they have been practicing, not practicing, but they have been working for the same company sometimes for 10, 12 years, and we are seeing different kinds of 221G. Quickly, 221G is a tool of administrative processing where the State Department, the U.S. Embassy, can block the case usually, and that can be sometimes indefinitely. We don't really have a timing, but usually can range from 30 days up to some cases I've seen 2 years. Most of the cases don't go 2 years though, but for many reasons they're doing that. And if you look at what they're asking for from people is that new form by the State Department asking you a lot of questions personal, which cities you have traveled, where are your social media accounts, and all those detailed things. I think what they're looking at is a background check, and that unfortunately takes time. And since 221G usually gets cleared within 30 days to 90 days, I think when they are reaching that level, there's a chance you're going to be in the 60 days kind of period of waiting. But and those for people who have kept their passport, because there are like three main kinds of 221G that we see. One where they ask for more documents, one where basically they are saying, hey, we want to do a background check, and the other one is usually when they send the case back, or they deny it, or they just hold it for whatever reason. Now the problem is, if we are talking about this strict background check, when they're asking a lot of questions about social media and everything, I wanted to mention that be very careful with what you write on social media. I know there are a lot of tension going on around the world, especially in India, Pakistan, etc. So whatever you write there can be used against you. And people don't realize that is that if the government decides to support one side, they can tell you you are supporting a group that that is not a group that basically considered that they are planning some kind of wrong things, etc. So you have to be careful, and it's happening a lot in India, and we are seeing the calls coming. I don't know, I didn't count it, but in 2 days I got like 6-7 calls for 221G, which is a lot, because those I usually get maybe once a month. So I am trying to tell people, bottom line, if you don't have to travel to go for stamping, please don't travel. And I know a lot of people went on vacation and they need to travel. If you have a stamp on your passport, very good, you don't have to go for stamping. But if you have to go for stamping, be ready for that. Now the next things that I'm expecting is that at the airport, they are going to start questioning people on the same questions you have on the list on that State Department form, including the places you visited, the cities you visited, the countries you visited, and your social media. The social media one is like the unfair part, because we are in America and the First Amendment should be applying. But the problem is that when you're outside the United States, United States doesn't have, you don't have jurisdiction to claim the First Amendment if you wrote something bad on your, especially a political thing. So be very careful what you write. I had a video on social media a long time ago, I think almost 6 years, 7 years ago, but now it's more relevant than ever. Be very, very careful in that. You can have a Facebook account, TikTok, you name it, but be very careful what you write there, what you comment on, because this is going to be a really fine comb now, and this is can come back and hurt you. If you need help, at least a guidance, what's happening on your 221G, there are not many things you can do, maybe contact a congressman and things like that, but at least we can guide you. You can call us for a consultation, even a second opinion, at 510-742-5887, 510-742-5887. Thank you.